Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com. The question that came in yesterday was, does enamel get damaged or do your teeth get damaged? Do they get scraped permanently when you remove the attachments, that's these guys, from Invisalign or another brand of clear aligners or even from braces? I've done a couple other videos on this, but it was more specifically going over the burr sequence that I use to get these off. And I have a lot of content made for the braces. I don't have a lot made for the Invisalign. So take a look at, like, debond would be the keyword if you want to watch those videos, or it's covered in our braces playlist or in our braces straightwire course, which is available at straightsmilesolutions.com under courses. Very affordable, only like $40 per CE unit. And you have a whole year to finish your CE class. Probably the most affordable braces course that's out there, I think. Anyways, so if, no, there's no reason you need to damage enamel is the answer to the question now, but I mean, will it be damaged? That really depends on how heavy-handed the doctor is. It has nothing to do with Invisalign or the procedure itself. It has to do with how heavy-handed the doctor is, and it really depends on how much time the doctor wants to put into the debond. And I'm not saying that if it's done quickly, that it's done badly. There might be people who are just really good with their hands, so don't freak out if they got it done in a minute. Basically, the way you kind of know that they're doing it right is they should use a sequence of burrs, okay? So usually for me, I'm gonna go ahead and start with a diamond burr, like a pretty coarse diamond, to get the rough amount off. So when I dry cut, I can kind of see when there's dust. If there's dust, we're still only on composite. We are not on tooth at all. It cuts differently. It has a different feel. It has a different look when you cut. So it's just a matter of experience. I'm gonna go ahead and get maybe 90% of it off, not touch the tooth at all. You might feel some vibrations in the tooth, but we're not cutting teeth. And then I'm gonna go ahead and switch to something more fine, either like a stone or a 12 fluted carbide. And I don't see an example of that here. This is probably like a carbide, doesn't have these little bumps on it. A carbide like has stripes. And it's just like little like notches in a carbide burr, so no diamonds on it. And maybe it might be like this, but I can't really see, it's a little blurry there. And a 12 fluted carbide is very, very fine. It's really, if it does touch your enamel at all, it's really not touching it. Same thing with a stone, it's gonna be very, very slow. You can also switch and put it on a slow speed, which is a different amount of RPMs. It doesn't turn as quickly, so it's less likely to remove enamel. But the thing is that enamel or tooth structure is harder than the tooth structure of the stone. It is not harder than the tooth structure of the diamond. So that's why the diamond can take off enamel. The stone can't really take off enamel. It can only take off the composite. I mean, you'd have to be really heavy-handed and sit there for a very long time. I mean, you could take like a rock that's sitting there, and if you rubbed it enough times with something, you'd get a groove in it, right? If you just kept rubbing it and grubbing it and rubbing with your fingernail or a key, right? In time, it would wear down, but you know, you'd have to repetitively do it, not just one stroke. So yeah, I mean, if you see like all kinds of like notches on your teeth, well, then they got your teeth. There shouldn't be notches or scratches on your teeth, on your natural teeth. Also, if you run an instrument over your teeth, you know, be it, I think I have some videos about that, like an Explorer or anything that's metal, you'd see a scratch if there's still composite left on your teeth. You'll see like a black mark, but you know, you can feel it with your fingernail. So if your doctor left glue on your tooth, you should go back to your doctor or go to another doctor. Usually people will take it off, maybe a small fee associated with it. But don't leave the orthodontist if there's still glue on your teeth. Call and say, hey, there's still glue on my teeth, you know? Come back, get it all off. Sometimes you know, little pieces left, especially if they're trying to be conservative and not be aggressive, they might leave a little bit, and that's not a big deal. They can get it off later. They should be totally cool to get it off at your next retainer check, or just give them a call and let them know there's still some on. All right. And if somehow they really did scratch up your teeth, then that's something you need to talk to them about. There's some treatments they can do. There's some polishing treatments, stuff like that. I mean, occasionally it happens. All right. Thanks so much.